you a mom? Do you remember the intensity of that moment, the first time that you became a mom and what you felt? Well, in today's chat and conversation, I'm sharing about my experience as a mom and the things that I wish I knew, that like, the surprises of motherhood, eh? That I've experienced as a mom. So join me in this conversation. Hi, my name is Erin and I do family related content. My passion is to see families and marriages thrive. So today we're having a conversation about motherhood and momming, and I'm basically sharing with you things that I wish I knew before I became a mom. So I'm a mom of two. My firstborn is 4 years and the other is 2 years. So I've been a mom since 2017 June. So it's been 4 years of change. My life hasn't been the same since that day in June in 2017. I've had so many surprises and I just want to share with you some of them today. So I hope you enjoy this video, and if you do, remember to subscribe. As a stay-home mom, one of the things that have surprised me is the amount of cleaning that I have to do on a daily. Guys, I have only two children, but I feel like I have to be picking up after them. I was telling you about how much cleaning I've had to do, and to be pretty honest, in my first year, I think, and second year of parenting, I didn't understand this so much because I had a maid and they were helping me, and I was usually away at work. But man, once I started being around, these past 2 years, you guys have cleaned. You clean diapers, you clean messes, you clean one. And you know, sometimes, you know, if you're doing it once a day, it's okay, because you wake up and you know, okay, I'm going to do this and it's done. Sometimes when you have just cleaned and you're all proud that you have a clean house, someone makes a mess and you literally like just want to wring their neck. So yeah, the cleaning bit, eh? Has really surprised me in motherhood. There's so much cleaning and you have to be patient as you train the kids to clean up after themselves. And you know, as you're training them that way, you have to be patient. They do it haphazardly and then you have to tolerate it. You people, motherhood. Yeah, there's a lot of cleaning. The second thing I would say that surprised me a lot about motherhood is that too much love like I'd feel for my children. Like, to be pretty honest, like, I'm not a lovey-dovey person of all, I don't know, like, so I thought like my mother-daughter relationship would be the same like any other relationship. I mean, the way I feel about my family, I love them, but I'm not always there constantly thinking about them, what they're doing, their future and things like that. But my god, like, when I got a child, it's like I stopped thinking about myself. Like, all the time I'm thinking about them, how to raise them, how to groom them, if I'm doing motherhood right, if I'm like, I just have too much love. And sometimes the love, confession time, sometimes the love interferes with discipline. Like, there are those moments when my children do something and I know that I must discipline them, but they look up at me with those adorable eyes and I'm just like, oh, she looks so cute, and then now I'm faltering in discipline. So I feel like motherhood softened me up. Like, it exposed that softness in me that I had never really felt. Like, the bond is just so, it's just too much, it's overwhelming. Like, that ability to love someone more than you love yourself, I hadn't experienced it before in my life. And it's nice to just have little girls that melt your heart. In addition to the love, what I also didn't expect from motherhood is the intensity of the responsibility. Like, the responsibility of motherhood is so heavy. Like, I feel it daily. It means like it rests on my chest daily. I feel like I have so much to do. You know, you have to train someone, you have to nurture them in the ways of God, you have to teach them morals, you have to provide for them, you have to, I mean, like, someone's life is literally in your hands. You have to steward them for those 18 years. And the weight of that responsibility, I feel like, is so heavy. I didn't, like, growing up, I didn't really feel like, I don't know how our parents did it, but they didn't make it seem so hard. I felt like my parents were just there. I mean, as long as we had something to eat and blah, blah. Maybe because I was not working. But now that I know how hard it is to earn a buck and just the things you have to do to raise a well-rounded child, that responsibility is so heavy. And that surprised me because I'm constantly thinking, as I homeschool my kids, am I teaching them enough? As I'm training them morals, am I teaching them enough? Am I being a good example? Am I feeding them right? Are they eating a balanced diet? Are they interacting with the right people? Am I too tough? Am I too soft? Like, it's just too much. Like, you feel like, okay, this is a big responsibility, and parenting is really a great responsibility that we must be intentional at, and also ask God to help us out in this journey, because these children are from Him and He knows best how we should be raising them. This is a confession. Me and my husband have always had like a good working relationship. We are usually on the same page. So I was not prepared for the amount of conflict having children that kind of brought us all into our relationship. Basically, when we were dating, the things we talked about children, we just asked ourselves, okay, how many kids do you want to have? And I was like, oh, me, I want a big family. I want 5 kids. And it's like, oh, okay, for me I want 3, but since you're the one who carries the children, we can have 5 if that's what you want. And that was it. We didn't think about like, how are we going to discipline the kids, how are we going to raise them. We didn't have those conversations. So when the kids came, we realized that we had to have those conversations. We had different parenting philosophies. One of us prefers beating, the other doesn't. One, you know, they were just different. There's barking and soft tone. We were clashing on so many things, and so we had to have conversations and agree how to raise them. What are the values we want to teach them? Like, how are they going to feed? How are they going to dress? Because yeah, those things are small, but they matter. You know, you get married to a man, you love him very much, and you don't know he's not going to want your kids to wear leggings. Like, you get me? Like, that becomes a point of contention. Like, they don't want the kids to go to the salon because apparently plaiting hair is painful. Like, there's so much conflict that can come with having children, and I was not prepared for that. We've had to work through a lot of things, have a lot of discussion, and I feel like we are now on a page where we agree a lot on how we should raise these kids. But the beginning times, yeah, there's a rough patch there. Finally, I now get it. I now understand moms who can't move, who can't come to parties, who can't go places just because they had kids. Like, I was not prepared for the loss of freedom that comes with being a mom. Like, before I was a mom, all you had to come is like, hello, Erin, are you free? There's this, and I would come. But now, because I don't have a maid, like, I literally move with my kids. So if we are to go anywhere, like, it needs so much planning. I'm thinking diapers, potty, bags. Like, when we are going out with my kids, you can think we are shifting. Like, it's just so much. First of all, I can't just go anywhere anytime I feel like I need to plan it. I need to get someone to leave the kids with. Like, I just don't have freedom anymore. It's parenting, it's motherhood, like, freedom gone. Where I didn't know. I feel like growing up also, I didn't think like my mom was so tied down to where I was, because I mean, she lived her life and was at home and things like that. And maybe this is also because of the fact that I'm home. But even when I was working, like, the days I was not working, I just wanted to be with my child. Like, so I lost that freedom, that ability to just pack up and go. I have to wake up and say, okay, where am I going to leave the kids? Are they going to be safe? Are they going to be okay? And when we are parking, banana, the bags are so many. You have to pack a basin, at a potty, at a diapers, clothes, nightwear, daywear, in case they get dirty, in case they susu. So I feel like my freedom of movement was affected. I'm curious, like, what are the things that surprised you about motherhood? Please share in the comment section, right? Let's let's engage and learn just different things, and also encourage each other in this journey of motherhood and parenting, because as tough and crazy as it can be, it can also be beautiful. Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe. Bye.